This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Empire State Building is a 102-story skyscraper located on 5th Avenue between West 33rd and 34th Streets in Midtown, Manhattan, New York City. It has a roof height of 1,250 feet 381 meters, and with its antenna spire included, it stands a total of 1,454 feet 443. The building is owned by the Empire State Realty Trust, of which Anthony Malkin serves as chairman, CEO, and president. In 2010, the Empire State Building underwent a $550,222 broadcast stations, 223 observation decks, 224 New York Skyride, 225 lights, 23 height records and comparisons, 24 neighboring Midtown Manhattan landmarks, 3 in popular culture, 31 film, 32 television, 33 literature, 34 other, 4 notable tenants, 5 gallery, 6 see also, 7 references, 8 external links. History. The site of the Empire State Building was first developed as the John Thompson Farm in the late 18th century. At the time, a stream ran across the site, emptying into Sunfish Pond, located a block away. Beginning in the late 19th century, the block was occupied by the Waldorf Astoria Hotel, frequented by the 400, the social elite of New York. The limestone for the Empire State Building came from the Empire Mill in Sanders, Indiana, which is an unincorporated town adjacent to Bloomington, Indiana. The Empire Mill land office is near State Road 37 and Old State Road 37, just south of Bloomington. The Bloomington, Bedford, and Oolitic area is known locally as the limestone capital of the world. Design and construction. A worker bolts beams during construction. The Chrysler Building can be seen in the background. The Empire State Building was designed by William F. Lamb from the architectural firm Shreve, Lamb & Harmon, which produced the building drawings in just 2 weeks, using its earlier designs for the Reynolds Building in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and the Carew Tower in Cincinnati, Ohio, designed by the architectural firm W.W. Alschlager. Governor of New York and James Farley's General Builders Supply Corporation supplied the building materials. John W. Bowser was project construction superintendent. Excavation of the site began on January 22, 1930, and construction on the building itself started on March 17, St. Patrick's Day. Per Al Smith's influence as Empire State, Inc. president, the project involved 3,400 workers, mostly immigrants from Europe, along with hundreds of Mohawk iron workers, many from the Conowake Reserve near Montreal. According to official accounts, 5 workers died during the construction. Governor Smith's grandchildren cut the ribbon on May 1, 1931. Louis Wicks Hines' photography of the construction provides not only invaluable documentation of the construction, but also a glimpse into common day life of workers in that era. The construction was part of an intense competition in New York for the title of world's tallest building. 2 other projects fighting for the title, 40 Wall Street and the Chrysler Building, were still under construction when work began on the Empire State Building. Each held the title for less than a year, as the Empire State Building surpassed them upon its completion. On April 11, 1931, 12 days ahead of schedule, just 410. Following year, was for the purpose of signaling the victory of Franklin D. Roosevelt over Hoover in the presidential election of November 1932. Opening view of the building from the north. The building's opening coincided with the Great Depression in the United States, and as a result much of its office space was initially unrented. The building's vacancy was exacerbated by its poor location on 34th Street, which placed it relatively far from public transportation, as Grand Central Terminal and Penn Station, built decades beforehand, are several blocks away, as is the more recently built Port Authority bus terminal. Other more successful skyscrapers, such as the Chrysler Building, did not have this problem in its first year of operation. The observation deck took in approximately 2:1945 plane crash. Main article, B-25 Empire State Building crash at 9:40 a.m. on Saturday, July 28, 1945. A B-25 Mitchell bomber, piloted in thick fog by Lieutenant Colonel William Franklin Smith, Jr., crashed into the north side of the Empire State Building, between the 79th and 80th floors, where the offices of the National Catholic Welfare Council were located. One engine shot through the side opposite the impact and flew as far as the next block, where it landed on the roof of a nearby building, starting a fire that destroyed a penthouse. The other engine and part of the landing gear plummeted down an elevator shaft. The resulting fire was extinguished in 40. From the upper parts of the building, the first suicide occurred even before its completion, by a worker who had been laid off the fence around the observatory terrace was put up in 1947 after five people tried to jump during a three-week span on December 16, 1943. Ex-United States Navy gunner's mate William Lloyd Rambo, 22, jumped to his death from the 86th floor, landing amidst Christmas shoppers on the street below in the early morning of September 27, 1946. Shell-shocked 27-year-old Marine Douglas W. Brashear Jr. jumped from the 76th floor window of the Grant Advertising Agency after phoning a co-worker to tell her, "I know now this is the end." Police found his shoes 50 feet from his body on May 1, 1947. 23-year-old Evelyn McHale leapt to her death from the 86th floor observation deck and landed on a limousine parked at the curb. Photography student Robert Wiles took a photo of McHale's oddly intact corpse a few minutes after her death. The police found a suicide note among possessions she left on the observation deck: "He is much better off without me. I wouldn't make a good wife for anybody." The photo ran in the edition of May 12, 1947 of Life magazine, and is often referred to as the most beautiful suicide. It was later used by visual artist Andy Warhol in one of his prints entitled Suicide: Fallen Body. Only one person has jumped from the upper observatory. On November 3, 1932, Frederick Eckert, of Astoria, ran past a guard in the enclosed 102nd floor gallery and jumped a gate leading to an outdoor catwalk intended for dirigible passengers. He landed and died on the roof. Of the 86th floor observation promenade, two people have survived jumps, in both cases by not falling more than a floor. On December 2, 1979, Elvita Adams jumped from the 86th floor, only to be blown back onto a ledge on the 85th floor by a gust of wind and left with a broken hip on April 25, 2013. A man, who is presumed to have jumped, fell from the 86th floor observation deck but landed alive on an 85th floor ledge, where security guards brought him inside with minor injuries. Shooting. Two major shooting incidents have occurred at or in front of the Empire State Building on February 23, 1997, at about 5. Architecture. The Empire State Building is seen across the East River, from Brooklyn. A series of setbacks causes the building to taper with height. Interior. The Empire State Building rises to 1,250. Pentagon. The building was completed in 1 year and 45. Bridges. At the second floor level, the elevator core contains 67 elevators. The lobby is 3 stories high and features an aluminum relief of the skyscraper without the antenna, which was not added to the spire until 1952. The north corridor contained 8 illuminated panels, created by Roy Sparkia and René Nemorov in 1963 in time for the 1964 World's Fair, which depicts the building as the 8th wonder of the world, alongside the traditional 7. These panels were eventually moved near a ticketing line for the observation deck until the 1960s. The ceilings in the lobby had a shiny Art Deco mural inspired by both the sky and the machine age, until it was covered with ceiling tiles and fluorescent lighting because the original murals, designed by an artist named Leif Neandros, were damaged. Reproductions were installed. Over 50 artists and workers used 15,000 square feet of aluminum and 1,300 square feet of 23-karat gold leaf to recreate the mural. Renovations to the lobby alluded to original plans for the building, replacing the clock over the information desk in the Fifth Avenue lobby with an anemometer, as well as installing 2 chandeliers originally intended to be part of the building when it first opened in 2000. The building's owners installed a series of paintings by the New York artist Kisa Johnson in the concourse level in January 2014. The artist filed suit in federal court in New York under the Visual Artists' Rights Act, alleging the negligent destruction of the paintings and damage to her reputation as an artist. The building's lobbies and common areas received a $550 million renovation in 2009, which included new air conditioning, waterproofing, and renovating the observation deck, moving the gift shop to the 80th floor of this, $120. To reach the spire for maintenance work. The building's Art Deco spire was designed to be a mooring mast and depot for dirigibles. An elevator between the 86th and 102nd floors would carry passengers after they checked in on the 86th floor. The idea proved impractical and dangerous, due to the powerful updrafts caused by the building itself, as well as the lack of mooring lines tying the other end of the craft to the ground. The building's design was expanded to include the mooring mast as part of a competition for the world's tallest building. A large broadcast broadcast tower was added atop the spire in the early 1950s, to support the transmission antennas of several television and FM stations. Until then, NBC had exclusive rights to the site, and, beginning in 1931, built various, smaller antennas for their television transmissions. Broadcast stations. New York City is the largest media market in the United States since the September 11th attacks. Nearly all of the city's commercial broadcast stations, both television and FM radio, have transmitted from the top of the Empire State Building, although a few FM stations are located at the nearby Condé Nast Building. Most New York City AM stations broadcast from sites across the Hudson River in New Jersey or from other surrounding areas. Antennae for broadcast stations are located at the top of the Empire State Building. Broadcasting began at the Empire State Building on December 22, 1931, when RCA began transmitting experimental television broadcasts from a small antenna erected atop the spire. They leased the 85th floor and built a laboratory there, and, in 1934, RCA was joined by Edwin Howard Armstrong in a cooperative venture to test his FM system from the building's antenna. When Armstrong and RCA fell out in 1935 and his FM equipment was removed, the 85th floor became the home of RCA's New York television operations, first as experimental station W2XBS Channel 1, which eventually became on July 1, 1941 commercial station WNBT, Channel 1 now WNBC-TV Channel 4. NBC's FM station WEAF-FM, now WQHT, began transmitting from the antenna in 1940. NBC retained exclusive use of the top of the building until 1950, when the FCC ordered the exclusive deal broken, based on consumer complaints that a common location was necessary for the now seven New York area television stations, five licensed to New York City, New York, one licensed to Newark, New Jersey, and one licensed to Secaucus, NJ, to transmit from, so that receiving antennas would not have to be constantly adjusted. Construction on a giant tower began. Other television broadcasters then joined RCA at the building, on the 83rd, 82nd, and 81st floors, frequently bringing sister FM stations along for the ride. Multiple transmissions of TV and FM began from the new tower in 1951. In 1965, a separate set of FM antennas was constructed ringing the 103rd floor observation area to act as a master antenna. When the World Trade Center was being constructed, it caused serious reception problems for the television stations, most of which then moved to the World Trade Center as soon as it was completed. This made it possible to renovate the antenna structure and the transmitter facilities for the benefit of the FM stations remaining there, which were soon joined by other FMs and UHF TVs moving in from elsewhere in the metropolitan area. The destruction of the World Trade Center necessitated a great deal of shuffling of antennas and transmitter rooms to accommodate the stations moving back uptown. As of 2012, the Empire State Building is home to the following stations: Television Broadcasting, WCBS-2, WNBC-4, WNYW-5, WABC-7, WWOR-9 Secaucus, WPIX-11, WNET-13 Newark, WNYE-25, WPXN-31, WXTV-41 Patterson, WNJU-47 Linden, and WFUT-68 Newark. FM Broadcasting, WBMP-923, WPAT-931 Patterson, WNYC-939, WPLJ-955, WXNY-963, WQHT-971, WSKQ-979, WEPN-987, WBAI-995, WHTZ-1003 Newark, WCBS-1011, WFAN-1019, WNEW-FM-1027, WKTU-1035 Lake Success, WAXQ-1043, WWPR-1051, WQXR-1059 Newark, WLTW-1067 and WBLS-1075 Observation Decks. The Empire State Building has one of the most popular outdoor observatories in the world, having been visited by over 110 Tourists may pay to visit the observation deck on the 86th floor and an additional amount for the 102nd floor. The lines to enter the observation decks, according to ConciergeCom, are as legendary as the building itself. There are five of them: the sidewalk line, the lobby elevator line, the ticket purchase line, the second elevator line, and the line to get off the elevator and onto the observation deck for an extra fee. Tourists can skip to the front of the line. The Empire State Building makes more money from ticket sales for its observation decks than it does from renting office space. The skyscraper's observation deck plays host to several cinematic, television, and literary classics, including An Affair to Remember, On the Town, Love Affair, and Sleepless in Seattle in the Latin American literary classic. Janina Brasci's Empire of Dreams. The observation deck is the site of a pastoral revolution. Shepherds take over the city of New York. The deck was also the site of a publicity stunt, Martian invasion, in an episode of I Love Lucy, Lucy is Envious, Season 3, Episode 25. A panoramic view of New York City from the 86th floor observation deck of the Empire State Building. Spring 2005. New York Skyride. The Empire State Building also has a motion simulator attraction located on the second floor, opened in 1994 as a complement to the observation deck. The New York Skyride, or NY Skyride, is a simulated aerial tour over the city. The cinematic presentation lasts approximately 25. Represent the singer's nickname, Old Blue Eyes. After the death of actress Faye Ray King Kong in late 2004, the building stood in complete darkness for 15. 2012, the building was lit in blue and white, the colors of the Israeli flag, in honor of the 49th annual Celebrate Israel parade. During 2012, the building's metal halide lamps and floodlights were replaced with LED fixtures, increasing the available colors from 9 to over 16 million. The computer-controlled system allows the building to be illuminated in ways that were unable to be done previously with plastic gels, for instance. On November 6, 2012, CNN used the top of the Empire State Building as a scoreboard for the 2012 United States presidential election, when incumbent President Barack Obama had reached the 270 electoral votes necessary to win re-election. The lights turned blue had Republican challenger Mitt Romney won. The building would have been lit red also. On November 26, 2012, the building had its first ever synchronized light show, using music from recording artist Alicia Keys. Those wishing to hear the music could tune to certain radio stations in the New York area. A video of the performance was posted online the next day. In 2013, the lights were changed to Financial Times pink in the run-up week to Super Bowl 48, held at MetLife Stadium on February 2, 2014. The building was lit in a contest sponsored by the National Football League's wireless partner, Verizon Wireless, to determine both the winner and fan support for the two teams via their team colors in the game through the hashtag Who's Gonna Win Twitter hashtag. Either the Action Green and Navy Blue of the Seattle Seahawks or Orange and Blue of the Denver Broncos, along with a light show during the game's halftime. Height records and comparisons. Height comparison of New York City buildings, with Empire State second from left. Size comparison in relation to the Pentagon. The Pentagon is 431 meters, 1,414. Surpassed by the Willis Tower, the Trump International Hotel and Tower Chicago, 432 Park Avenue, and the new One World Trade Center. One World Trade Center surpassed the roof height of the Empire State Building on April 30, 2012, and became the tallest building in New York City, on the way toward becoming the tallest building in the Americas at a planned 1,776. In popular culture, film The Midtown Skyline, as viewed from the observation deck at night in January 2006. 1933 movie poster for King Kong. A frame from the 1933 film of King Kong. Perhaps the most famous popular culture representation of the building is in King Kong 1933, in which the title character, a giant ape, climbs to the top to escape his captors but falls to his death after being attacked by airplanes in 1983. For the film's 50th anniversary, a huge 90-foot 27 buildings lobby and observatory in the Looney Tunes cartoon Much Ado About Nutting, a squirrel has so much difficulty opening a coconut he carries it to the Empire State Building's observation deck and tosses it over the edge while the street is damaged by the impact. The coconut remains intact in the 1946 Looney Tunes cartoon Baseball Bugs. Bugs Bunny is pitching in the polo grounds against the Gashouse Gorillas in the bottom of the ninth, with two outs and Bugs protecting a one-run lead. The opposition hits the ball out of the park for an apparent apparent game-winning two-run homer Bugs pursues the ball through New York City. The chase culminates at the Empire State Building. Bugs ascends to the top of the building by elevator and catches the ball for the third out, winning the game in the Tom and Jerry cartoon Mouse in Manhattan. Jerry walks by and views the Empire State Building, along with other landmarks, including the statue of Atlas at Rockefeller Center and Grand Central Terminal. Andy Warhol's 1964 silent film Empire is one continuous, 8-hour black-and-white shot of the Empire State Building at night. In 2004, the National Film Registry deemed its cultural significance worthy of preservation in the Library of Congress in Percy Jackson's floor, which is supposed to be Olympus. Just like in the book series, the building is chosen as ground zero for the target of a nuclear bomb that is dropped on New York in fail-safe 1964. Both Zero Mostel and Gene Wilder go to the observation deck of the building in the original Mel Brooks film The Producers in the Time Machine 2002. The Empire State Building is still standing in the year 2030, but dwarfed by several larger skyscrapers around it. It is not visible in later scenes set in a post-apocalyptic New York in Sky Captain and the World of Tomorrow 2004. The top of the building serves its original purpose of being a docking station for dirigibles, and the Hindenburg 3 docks at it on its maiden voyage. The building starred in Enchanted 2007, which Giselle tried to rescue Robert from Queen Nerissa in her dragon form. Many films have opened with the Empire State Building, such as West Side Story 1961, Step Up 3D and The Other Guys both 2010. The building has been destroyed in some disaster films, such as Independence Day 1996 and Knowing 2009. In The Divide 2011, the building is destroyed by a nuclear bomb detonated on New York. It was heavily featured on posters promoting the film in Superman 2 1980. Ursa Sarah Douglas uses a flagpole to knock Superman Christopher Reeve into the tower of the Chrysler Building. He ducks with non-Jack O'Halloran taking the blast. However, scenes showing the tower falling and being flown back to the top by Superman are of the Empire State Building in The Fifth Wave. The building happens to survive a massive tsunami that hits Manhattan during an alien invasion. Many other films that feature the Empire State Building are listed on the building's own website. Television in the 1965 four-part Underdog cartoon serial The Phony Booths episodes 49-52, Underdog falls under the mental control of mad scientist Simon Barr. Sinister Simon orders Underdog to use his superpowers to bring him valuable objects, including the Empire State Building, which Underdog lifts whole to bring it to Simon. In the end, circumstances release Underdog from Simon's control. He defeats the evil scientist and puts back the Empire State Building. The Empire State Building featured in the 1966 Doctor Who serial The Chase, in which the TARDIS lands on the roof of the building. The Doctor and his companions leave quite quickly, however, because the Daleks are close behind them. A Dalek is also seen on the roof of the building while it interrogates a human. In 2007, Doctor Who episodes Daleks in Manhattan and Evolution of the Daleks also featured the building, which the Daleks are constructing to use as a lightning conductor. Russell T. Davies said in an article that, in his mind, the Daleks remembered the building from their last visit in the science fiction drama series Fringe. The observation deck of the Empire State Building serves its primary purpose as a docking station for Zeppelins in the parallel universe shown in the second season episode Peter. The Discovery Channel show Mythbusters tested the urban myth which claims that if one drops a penny off the top of the Empire State Building, it could kill someone or put a crater in the pavement. The outcome was that, by the time the penny hits the ground, it is going roughly 65. Episode. The music video of the song Everything is Everything by singer Lauryn Hill prominently features the Empire State Building as the center of a city record turntable in the episode First Time in New York of the television series How I Met Your Mother, originally aired on January 8, 2007. The gang takes Robin's sister Katie to the Empire State Building on the first day. They only got to the lobby, but they eventually went to the top the next day. Literature. H.G. Wells' 1933 science fiction novel The Shape of Things to Come, written in the form of a history book published in the far future, includes the following passage. Up to quite recently, Lower New York has been the most old-fashioned city in the world, unique in its gloomy antiquity. The last of the ancient skyscrapers, the Empire State Building, is even now under demolition in CE 2106. David Macaulay's 1980 illustrated book Unbuilding depicts the Empire State Building being purchased by a Middle Eastern billionaire and disassembled piece by piece to be transported to Saudi Arabia and rebuilt there. The mooring mast is rebuilt in New York, while the remainder of the building is lost at sea. Janina Brasci's Empire of Dreams, a Latin American poetry epic published in 1988. featured a pastoral revolution on the top floor of the Empire State Building, where shepherds danced and sang songs of revolution. The Empire State Building is featured prominently as both a setting and integral plot device throughout much of Michael Chabon's 2000 Pulitzer Prize-winning novel, The Amazing Adventures of Cavalier Ace's other A 76 Feet 23. Filipino Reporter, Suite 1007 Human Rights Foundation, Suite 4515 Human Rights Watch, 34th Floor Kaplan International Center, 63rd Floor Lee Shenley Gallery Sunrise December 2005 Spire seen from east on 34th Street 2013 as seen from Queens during sunset August 2016 as seen from Washington Square Park as seen from ground level on 35th Street as seen from Broadway and 21st Street as seen from the distance at sunset view from Weehawken, New Jersey Street level side view, 2013 Griffin Sculptures over front entrance, 2013 looking up from the observation deck looking down looking toward Times Square lit in purple for the National Purple Heart Day mural of the building, located in the lobby Art Deco elevators in the lobby. Building souvenir lit in red and green lights for Christmas, as seen from the GE building with Christmas lights lit in yellow to promote the Simpsons movie home video release lit in yellow and red during the 60th anniversary of the PRC lit in blue after Barack Obama was declared winner of the 2012 United States presidential election in the U.S., red commonly represents Republicans, blue for Democrats. See also New York City Portal Architecture Portal List of buildings with 100 floors or more List of tallest buildings in the World List of tallest buildings in the United States List of tallest buildings in New York City List of tallest buildings by U.S. State List of tallest freestanding structures in the world History of the tallest skyscrapers References Notes The Empire State Building is located within the 10001 zip code area, but 10118 is assigned as the building's own zip code, according to the United States Postal Service AB. Depending on the source, the floor count of the Empire State Building is variously cited as 102 or 103. The sources cited here all state 102. See here for a detailed explanation. Citations AB. Willis, Carol 1995, Empire State Building. In Kenneth T. Jackson, The Encyclopedia of New York City, New Haven, Connecticut. Development Project Consumer Price Index Estimate 1800, Federal Reserve Bank of Minneapolis, retrieved October 21, 2016. Information System National Register of Historic Places, National Park Service. Certification Inhabitat New York City, Inhabitat.com, retrieved October 12, 2011. 2010. Empire State Building withstood airplane impact TMs.org retrieved October 11, 2010.